Get ready for the dictation. Dictation will start in 5 seconds. Start. The meeting of the International Monetary Fund at Washington to consider the general revision of the exchange values of the currencies of all the member countries was being held on Saturday, the 17th, the day on which we came to our final decision. But I was informed by Mr. Chintaman Deshmukh that he was able to get the International Monetary Fund to postpone the examination of our case until Sunday so that we might have a little more time to examine the position. At 3 p.m. on Saturday, on the decision arrived at by the cabinet, I sent a cable to Washington to say that we would propose to the International Monetary Fund that the rupee should be devalued in the manner that we decided on. I wanted at that time to inform our neighbors, Ceylon and Pakistan, of our decision to make this proposal to the International Monetary Fund, but I could not very well do it on Saturday because Saturday was a business day, and I thought, in view of the great delicacy and secrecy attaching to this particular matter, that the earliest time when I could send a message safely to our neighbors was Sunday morning. On Sunday morning, therefore, I dispatched two telegrams, one to the Ceylon government and the other to the government, Pakistan government, informing them that we were making this proposal to the International Monetary Fund. I would like to make a reference to Ceylon in this connection because my friend, the finance minister of Ceylon, immediately and after devaluation was decided on both of his currency and of ours, made a statement in this parliament to the effect that he had not been consulted by the Indian government. I want to place before the House the facts in this connection. 2 days before, we received the message from Mr. Attlee because of the rumors which started all over the world regarding the possible decision of the UK government. The High Commissioner of Ceylon came to see me on the 14th, that is, as I said, 2 days before we received this message from Mr. Attlee, and he said there were all these rumors about devaluation, and in view of the close currency relations between Ceylon and India, he thought it was necessary that the two countries should act in consultation with each other. I entirely agree with the view that he put before me, and I told him two things. First of all, the matter had not been formally and officially considered by our cabinet in view of the conclusions reached in the expert investigations that had been gone on for long, full stop.